So yesterday we have seen like how to write literature article. Today, like additional to that, we'll be learning something like how to search articles and while writing what are the important things we need to consider and how to make some good graphical images, taking some images from an article. So something like kind of live training you'll be seeing it, okay? About like something about citations and all this. So now I'll be teaching about like some of the resources for finding scientific article. There are so many websites. So people used to search only in Google Scholars, okay? So these are some of the other websites. So you'll be seeing one by one. Google Scholar, I think most of the researchers were more familiar with searching articles. You can find like based upon the custom range option in the website, you can select some ranges. For example, if you're writing a literature article, maybe like in the next week, okay, like from 2020, from this date to the earlier, like last 3 years or last 4 years, 4 years, you can put those ranges and you can collect the literatures. Okay, you can put some keywords, and there may be some research article that will be more relevant to your literature review article title. Okay, in that case, you can go through that cited option also. For example, MR, first article you can see here, MR damper and its application for semi-active control for vehicle suspension system. Okay, so if you go through that 531 cited articles, so all the 500 plus articles will be relevant to this article. Okay, if not 500, at least 400 articles will be more closer to these works. Okay, and there is another option you can see, related articles. Okay, so this related articles also will be more relevant to this title only, this related articles. Okay, so you need to do one option is through related article searches as well as cited option, you need to search it, and another option is based upon the year, the custom range searches, you need to collect the articles which is like recently published articles for the last 3 years or 4 years. And next, Science Direct, which is having nearly like 12 million piece of research articles and nearly 3,500 academic journals and 34,000 ebooks. So here you can search by keywords or by author names or by title of book or journal or any volume number, issue number. Based upon that, you can search it. And here it has most of the discipline like physical science, life science, health science, social science, and all the discipline. And Scopus also has covered more number of titles, nearly 36,000 titles. In currently, if you see the recent source list of Scopus has more than 41,000, 40 plus 40,000 plus source list, like number of name of the journals. Okay, approximately around 11,678 publishers where they are publishing journals where we need indexed in Scopus and they are making it. So there also you can search some literatures. And then Mindly, it's also run by the elsewhere publishers on their sources.
You, I have no problem.
Okay, so you can use Mindly also. Obviously, that is going to help you for as a reference manager. At this same time, you can collect more number of OpenSS articles in Mindly. So if you are searching so many keywords, you'll be able to easily access the OpenSS articles by searching itself. For example, if you are searching in Google Scholar, you will be not able to find which article is OpenSS and which article is not an OpenSS. But this Mindly easily can separate the work, and there is an option for refining the search results. Refining the search results. And then Crossref. So this is the digital object identifier provider. For example, every article will be having a DOI number, which is a digital object identifier number. It's a unique number given for every article. Okay. So Crossref is a company, those who provide this DOI number. So those article title which is providing this DOI number, all those informations will be available in this Crossref database. Okay, so you can search like Crossref metadata. You can go through various, like not only articles, you can find like data sets. You can see here journal article, chapter, conference papers, monographs, reports, books, all those information will be available in these source websites. And then Research Gear also, you can find more number of literatures. Some articles you'll be able to download it, and some articles you need to send the full text request to the authors and you need to collect the article. Some researchers, even though it is, the article may be not available in SciHub, then even though in ResearchGate, Academia, anywhere if it is not available, just drop a mail to the corresponding author and get the article. Okay, that is also an option. It doesn't mean only because some articles you'll be able to find and some articles you may not be able to collect it. Okay. Then Academia, it's also an academic social network. Here also you can find the articles. And for example, if I'm searching some keyword, there will be more number of article you can able to download it. But there are some charges, like you need to go for the premium subscription and you need to get. So that is the disadvantage of this Academia, because many people cannot be afford to buy this premium and use it. So similar articles may be available in other sources like ResearchGate also. And then Semantic Scholar also, you can able to find some literatures relevant to your research works. And PubMed, mostly the Medline, like relevant to the medical and other abstract. And there, biomedical topics you can find in this topic. Like it's like a National Library of Medicine. Okay. InfoNow, it's I think morely for Poland, German. So some countries, their publications were added in these search results, InfoNow. And Sightseer is a public search engine for an academic papers, morely for computer and information science. Okay, computer and information science. Then Microsoft Academic, obviously it's the literature is mainly for mostly like computer science discipline, and some other interdisciplinary research works articles also you'll be finding in this Microsoft Academic. Okay. Then DBLP, it's like computer science biography search website that's been run by University of Trier from Germany. And here also you can find more number of literatures, mostly like kind of programming, like computer science, machine learning, artificial intelligence. Some of the recent technological advanced interdisciplinary research works you can able to find in this website. And UIAJ, this is purely a director of open access journals you can find over here. For example, I have searched, as you see on the screen, I have searched the keywords title Emma Damper, and I'm able to find nearly 137 results were found. So all these article titles will be freely, I will be able to download and I can be able to use for my research work. And Silo, it's an electronic library, sorry, covering most of the Brazilian journals. So Brazilian journals, all those, if you see, like for example, Mechanical Journal of like Civil Engineering, sorry, Journal of Civil and Mechanical Engineering is the journal. So that run by this Brazilian company named like Silo. So they are handling all these handling the electronic library. Okay. So all those articles will be also indexed in this Silo. And if you are specifically, if you are looking for an article only in that country alone, you can go through this source and you can collect the literatures. And RCU is run by the Cornell University. Here also in terms of some of the subjects like physics, mathematics, quantitative biology, quantitative finance and statistics, such a discipline article you can find in these websites. So here even I have searched along to my keywords, damper, and I'm able to find nearly 148 search results. And Dune is a free online search tool for downloading the free full text scholarly articles. And Base, it's a Biofield academic search engine by Biofield University Germany. They are taking care of these websites. Here we have various options like basic search, advanced search options. So you can search like if you want an entire document or just an abstract alone or a title alone. If you are, so you need to search and you need to find it. And then Biomed, it's like a Springer Nature has been handling this. Here also, so you can find relevant literatures and free full PDF. This is also in search engine for full papers, patents, theses, as well as some of the posters. Nearly 80 million articles you'll be able to download it. And SSRN, earlier it is a separate website, and now this has been taken care of by the Elsewhere group, and they have been handling this website. And then IEEE, mostly about the electrical engineering, instrumentation, computer science, relevant, like mostly on electronic discipline. Most of their journals will be available in IEEE. And assessing scientific paper, there are various options. Like sometime your institute will be having a subscription to this, all this journal or these publishers, subscriptions will be there. That is the case, it will be easier. And if that is not there, you can try go for the open access options, or some institute, the library, you'll be having the hard copy of some of the journals. Okay, if that is an option, or you can use some of the research tools like Mendeley, you can search some literatures, or Sotero, or various other tools you can collect. And there are some social academic network websites like Academia, ResearchGate, and there you can find some articles. So by searching these titles, you can try to download the articles through like SciHub, LibGen, all those things. And or you can have some collaboration with some of the students or your colleagues or faculties from some reputed institutes. They'll be having those access to download all the literatures. And this is how this is SciHub for downloading the articles. And this is how the LibGen will be. Just you need to copy and paste the title or DOI number, digital object identifier number, and just search it. So here you can find, I'm just searching this title. And you need to, there are four options at the end. You can find the mirror option, like SciHub, LibGen, Book, AC, and LibGen. So that LibGen LC.LC or LibGen.me, just you click it, and you'll be getting this screen. Just click that get option. If you click that get option, it will be, the article will be downloaded. Okay. And in some case, if you want some research article, you can use this ESET library. So you need to type this, type the website name like bookac.xyz. And here's an option, you can download the books also. Not only the articles, you can even download the books also. And now in PowerPoint, because yesterday I was telling you, like, if you're collecting for literature articles some images from various articles, so like you'll be making some kind of figure caption, and you'll be adding one or two figures, making some borders. Just a kind of a sample I'll be showing you in online, like in live. Just click the insert option in PowerPoint, click the image, click this device option. For example, in desktop, I think there is an image. So for example, this image may be from one journal. And in the same journal, I'm taking another image, which is more relevant to the objective or the title of the literature article. So two images, size may be different. So just click here. For example, if it is 2.9, and just click 3, and it is like 4.01. Again, here also, just click 3. Okay. Just make it near. And now here, the background color is black. Okay. So directly, you can just type in white color, just A, or for example, and this clicking here. See, you can make this option. Okay, let's copy and paste. This is an option, or just fill this hole in white color and just make the letter in black color. This is also an option. Okay. So you can use any one. A and B, and for just putting the borders, just Control A and just group it. Control G, okay. Control A for selecting all. Control G for grouping it. Just click the rectangle option, which my mouse is just clicking here. And just clicking the left hand. Just make this box, rectangle box. Just have the shape fill color as white, and click shape outline as black, and again click the shape outline and click the weight option. So it will be some 2 1 by 4 is fine. Just click this and send to back, and just click Control A and again group it, and just save this as a picture. While saving, try to save in TIFF format. Try to save it in TIFF format. Okay. So this is how, if you are having like this, some journals may be having, like, based upon the title, the way which you are writing, maybe having a single images or two, three images. And while you are writing the figure caption, just you need to mention figure A, figure FIG dot 1, and A comma, A, what is the A and what is B and what is C, that you need to mention it, okay. And then for citation, consider this is a introduction part of your research article. I just opened a Word file and I have copied an abstract from some other article. So just for an example, consider this as an, one second, I'll just reduce a few so that, okay, I'll reduce this off. So consider this as an introduction part. So I'm just, see, before opening that, just go to this Mendeley option, check whether it is signed in or not. It is signed in, and click here also. This is Mendeley desktop tool. Just check whether this is also in sign in. Okay, so already I have added so many number of articles here, not so many, like some number of articles were added in this Mendeley profile. And here also, I can, if you click this library, the same whatever the articles I have added here, it will be added there also. Okay, kind of some synchronization using that. This both can see here, here. So both were been. It has been synced. So this article, it is available twice. Just click and delete it. Delete the files. See, so make this everything is on. Just I'm telling, I think purely this is not for this Mendeley. So just to share like how the citation can be more easier for you for like literature article, because other technical papers you will be having some 20-30 articles in reference, but while you are writing a literature article, you'll be having like 100, 150, 200 literatures. So handling, making this index citation and all those things, it will be more difficult, okay? So in that case, if you are using these types of referencing tool, it will be more easier. So you can click this after installation of this Mendeley, click this reference option. For example, here in the fourth line after the concept, just I'm clicking the insert citation. You can search by author or title or year. Just I'm typing like something like year 2020 maybe. Okay, here is an article. Just I'm clicking this article and click OK. Now this article it has been added. Okay, then I am adding another article at the last before line. Near to that theory, click insert citation, maybe like Daniel Lincoln. So I will take this article and click OK. And again, at last, I'm adding one more article, click insert citation. Okay, I've added another article, click OK. Now here you can find nearly three articles I have added. Just click reference and click here in the top, there is an option called insert bibliography. When I click this insert bibliography, you can see all the reference. How this referencing style is there. Based upon that, you can find the author's name, year, and the journal name is in italic. Journal name is in italic. Then the volume number is also in italic. And the page number and the DOI numbers, everything is in. Perfect. Now, this is the American Psychological Association, APA 6th edition. Okay. Sometimes in civil engineering, in elsewhere, there is a journal name structures. You can here at last structures. Okay, just I'm clicking. If I'm submitting my article to that journal, it will be, this is how it will be like. If the citation will be numerical 1, 2, 3. Okay, so based upon that format, the article will be, this will be changing. So again, if you want more number of styles, okay, if I want like just I may be searching, there is a journal name like some engineering or something, just searching it. There are so many journals in this name, engineering, advances in engineering, Insha. So this is one of the journals. Just I'm like installing, click install. This install, and I click install option. And just collecting that Insha, the first journal, and I'm clicking that use this style. Click done. So based upon that journal format, now it has been changed. Okay. Here you can find this 117. This is not, not in italic, it's normal only. And here you can see earlier it is like mechanical system is mentioned fully, okay, but now here it is not. The first journal name, it is written in short, like mechanical is mentioned as mech and system is like SOST. So based upon the format, based upon their journal requirement, it will be changed. In case your article may be rejected in some journals, okay, you don't want to worry, just you change the style from this to another style, it will be the every formats will be changed according to that. Every formats will be the referencing and the citation style will be changed according to that. So this for writing literature review article, these types of referencing tool will be more helpful. Okay, just I am adding this insert, adding the articles here 1, 2, 3, 4 and something, and finally just I am clicking the insert bibliography and all this reference has been added here. All this reference has been added. This is one one of the tools for writing literature article you can use it. Then some researchers, they don't want these tools and insert the install the software, not software, this thing. In that case you can use the citation machine. Okay, for example, I am researching in okay, for example, see, click, I am copying this title. Now this is a website named citation machine. Here you can click create citation. Just click create citation. And this is the journal. Just click journal. And I am just searching the title or DOI number. I am searching through title. The article title is Effect of Grout Properties. So this is the first article. I am just clicking cite option. And then I am clicking again the continue option. And finally, there is an option called complete citation. Just click the complete citation. So here you can find, currently this is in APA 7th edition. APA 7th edition. Just when I just drag my mouse here, there is a two option. One is copy citation, another one is copy index to citation. Just I am clicking copy citation. Okay, just I am adding in the Word file. Just you can see here. We click the copy citation, which is based upon the referencing style. If some journals their referencing style will be APA 7th edition. Okay, so just I have clicked that option. Or again another option, for example, if it is not APA 7th edition, if it is APA 6th edition. So just if you click APA 6th edition, it will be changed automatically. Just I click the copy citation and I'm just pasting here. So here the difference of between the APA 7th edition and APA 6th edition is just this HTTPS link. You can see some HTTPS link here. Right, so in 7th edition you can find this HTTPS link, 6th edition you will be not able to find this link, but moreover most of the things were same. Okay, so even as this, see, if the journal is asking you for APA 7th edition but you are submitting a 6th edition, if you are having like 60 articles or 100, if you are having 200 articles also, those articles will not get the citation credit. So if you are, see, as obviously for article as we are spending more number of time, at the same time for giving the citation and reference also we need to spend some time so that the existing literatures or the existing authors, they will be also get, will be acknowledged through the citations. Okay, and then again okay, once again, so this is the citation option. When you drag here, there is another option named copy index to citation. If you click this index to citation, you can find your cycle, so and so, and this is the title. Okay, obviously for index citation you will not have the title. Just click copy. I think this is for the second one. Just so this is how the index citation will be. Inside the article, the title, the APA 6th edition will be looks like this. Okay, so this is also another option, because some don't want to some installation of software, but that is good. Mainly many researchers were using it. Then again, the same article you can use in cross-ref metadata also. For example, I'm just copying the title of this article. I think the just you need to search it. For example, so I think it is taking some time. So I'm moving to another tool named Math File. Okay. So for example, this is my Word file. Just I'm deleting all the reference. So now, for example, after this sentence, I need to add some equations. So just I'm clicking Control E. So as I install my Math Drive, to open that Math Drive, I have used this short key. So this is on the Math Drive equation editor. Okay, looks so already I have saved some equations. So if you go through this, the last two equations, you can see here. See, there are the every equation option is there. For example, the first, one second, like the first is the relational symbols. The next is spaces, and that is the embellishments, and like operator symbols are there, then arrow symbols, the logical symbols, set theory. Just if you click, you can find all the symbols over here. Okay. Like these are some of the math symbols, like new, theta, next, like Greek characters, then brackets. Then fraction and all those things, then subscripts and superscripts. Okay, so for example, here just when I click this 1/2, it has been added here. If you want to delete that, I can just delete that. Click delete expression, it has been deleted. So here I have added two more equations which frequently I am using. Just I'm clicking that equation, so you can find this here. Okay, so if I'm adding some more equation part over here after this. Okay, for an example, I'm just adding all those things. So if this is a new equation, so just I need to control A, select it, and just I need to paste here. So that in case again in future if I'm using it, I do not want to write the whole thing from the first to the last. Okay. So this the equation editor, many researchers they have been using, because yesterday when I was showing one example for the literature article, so they are using some equation. Like some of because some discipline when you are writing a review work of a mathematical way or an analytical investigation about various articles, obviously you need to write some equations and you need to give the citations. So if you are writing more number of equations for the whole, like for example 15-20 articles, more number of equations, it will be difficult to use like Word or some other tools, right? So even that some may be working well, and like some symbols you have to search everywhere, but here it will be more easier because as those symbols were separated in terms of fraction, all like Greek characters, as this subscript, superscript, as it is separated, it will be more easy for you to make the equation variable. Okay, so for example, just I am deleting this, just even deleting this even, just the delete option. For example, just I'll click like EA. So here you can find for example superscript, just I click here, so A square. Okay, then if I click the right arrow, it will come down. Just I'm clicking the plus option, and for example I'm clicking just B, and again clicking the superscript, just clicking square. Okay, then just plus or something, then for superscript just I'll click this both. Sorry, this word maybe. Sorry. Just all those equations. Just you can just easily can identify, because this option the matrix. Okay. Here are some of the matrix is there. Okay, this is matrix here. Some few templates are there. Okay. So you need to have some. some kind of brackets. Just you need to see it. So all your equation can be used by this MathType tool, and it will be more pro. For example, I am just having this. I'm having this, and again I'm just doing Control E, and here you can see here. Okay, so this will be like many researchers are using for their article writing purpose also. But in while writing a literature review, obviously when you are doing like referring more number of literatures, this equation editor will be more helpful. The equation editor will be more helpful to type the equations. Okay. I think regarding this crossref, there is some issues were there. So here also you can search. Here also this I have searched. This is the first article. Just click the action option and click cite option, and here you can find some of the formats: RIS, APA, Harvard, IEEE, and MLA. See, even in Google Scholar, when you click the cite option, you can find these options: APA, Harvard, IEEE. Sorry, IEEE will not be there. MLA, Vancouver, and Chicago. But in Google Scholar citation, when you are clicking it, you will be not able to find the DOI numbers, digital object identifier number. But here, you will be able to find the DOI numbers here. For example, if you see here the Chicago format. The DOI number is added here. Okay, so you can use, like, there are so many options, like, which is more like easier for you, like more familiar. You can use that, and you can add these types of technique tools while writing your literature review articles. And in case if you are want to create some new images for your literature article, just you can use this Inkscape. Many researchers, they use Inkscape for drawing some images, kind of flow charts. For example, how many number of articles you have collected, and how many number of articles you have been selected, and you'll be having some separation. Like if you're making some flow charts, you can use PowerPoint even making some flow charts. You can use these types of some new tools, because these figures or images, whichever when you are saving it, some good, it will be in some kind of good quality. So that is the reason many researchers, they use this Inkscape for making some flowcharts, figures, making some borders, some even for graphical abstract researchers, they used to work on this Inkscape. Okay. I think. So any query regarding these topics? Any queries, like kindly shoot your query in the chat box, or you can unmute and ask your queries. And other than this is like how you are managing your Excel sheet. You not any tools, any way how you can separate that kind of tabulation you are making it. If you are taking some 100 articles, and that 100 articles belongs to various themes, and you need to separate that. And in between, like every article will be they may be using some methodology, or they may be using some software, or they may be using some analytical techniques. So using some material, each and everything. Okay, they have, even their results may be everything you can add. Okay. Everything you can add and you can use it. And Uma Alapati sir, ma'am, reference tool like mainly is open. Yeah, it's open tool. It's an open tool. Even few researchers, they use Zotero, EndNote, but Mendeley is fine. Just I'm using Mendeley. Even Zotero, I am just used. I'm the Mendeley advisor. I mean, like there's a program called Mendeley advisor program. So I'm Mendeley advisor. Zotero is also many researchers were using one, but Zotero, I think 200 or some 300 MB is free. More than that, it is like we need to pay for them. Even Mendeley till 2 GB it is free. So if you are a Mendeley advisor, around like some 7 GB, it's free. 7 GB.
So how to increase this memory, sir?
That Mendeley advisor program?
Yeah.
No, no?
Yes, sir.
I will share that link.
And one more thing, sir. As we just install this Mendeley, we will be able to see in our Word document as a reference tool.
Yes, ma'am.
Automatically, it will be adding there. We do not have to do
it
any
extensions at all. Or you don't want to add it. Some case, if it is not adding it, in the Mendeley website itself, there will be an option called plugin.
Okay.
So if you just click that plugins, it will be added to your Word file. Just I will share you that link. Mendeley Advisor program. Just.
I'm not able to see your screen, sir.
Yeah, just I'm because like here is the link. I'm just sharing. Now. So this is the. Website, just I will copy and I am sharing this link here. So this is the become an advisor. Just click here. It will take 30 days for approval. But if you are suddenly just first, it's first don't apply here. Try to use this Mendeley for minimum of some 2 to 4 weeks. Minimum of 2 to 4 weeks. Just use it for some reference citation and all those things. Then you try to apply it, okay, so that they will know that you are using this Mendeley, all those things. So here are some of the teaching materials, Mendeley presentations, referencing guide, Mendeley data presentations, even checklist, advisor lesson plan. So all this they have provided. Just if you are an advisor, you will get a chance to share about Mendeley, all those things in various events. Thank you.